Background. So I matched with our star Neckbeard on Tinder on the 4th of July. We'll call him A. From his pics, he looked really cute and nerdy. A isn't really into anime and video games like most Neckbeards are, but he is really obsessed with metal and rock and roll. I have a thing for nerdy guys, so I was happy he messaged me first. He was overly flirty with me, which made me take a few steps back thinking he didn't want anything serious. He actually was looking for something more than hooking up, and it meant when he said how beautiful I was. So we start chatting more and getting to know each other more. As I'm getting to know him more, he starts telling me that he's in poor health. He has Crohn's disease, IBS, and all these other stomach problems. First red flag I should have noticed. He is also prone to getting large cysts on his ass cheeks, and he would sometimes get very detailed about those too. Gross. Now, I felt bad for him because he was actually in the hospital due to one of his cysts rupturing. He was admitted for a week, and he had no visitors besides his mom. Also, he told me that he hasn't had a girlfriend in 8 years. To say I felt sorry for him, and I continue talking with him. The date. The day of our date finally arrives, and he buys tickets in advance for us to see the new Lion King, and wants to take me out for dinner afterwards. Problem is, A is 28 years old, and not only does he not have a car, but he never got his driver's license. Another red flag. But I agreed to go and pick him up regardless. Mental note. I have never met this guy before this moment, and have never seen full body pictures of him. Only selfies and random shit from Snapchat. So I arrive at his house, which he lives in, which I can only describe as a trailer park with his mom, and out comes this 400-pound man. Sorry. Out comes this 400-pound man, which I never would have thought was A, but it was A. He fits the total description of a neckbeard. Overweight, shitty beard, and a pungent aroma, even though he just showered. Now, here comes the date part. We decide to eat before the movie as an attempt to spend less on food. You know the dinner he promised me? It was Taco Bell. Because Taco Bell is like crack to him, his exact words. We get our food and he is sweating profusely because he is extremely nervous. Also, he is burping like crazy due to said nerves and IBS. He also says grassy ass instead of thank you, like the white girls do. His words again. Damn, if I wasn't turned off before this moment, I was now. So we eat, go to Walmart and buy cheap candy to sneak in, and then go see the movie. This motherfucker talked loudly all throughout the movie. When he wasn't doing that, he was either burping lots again or getting up to use the bathroom. I never wanted to go home more in my entire life. I dropped him off at his place, he kissed me, tried to make out with me, but I just said I needed to go home. I cried the whole drive home, not because of how disgusting he was, but because of how I would eventually have to break ties with him. I hate hurting people, and knowing that I would become public enemy number one the next day just crushed me. So it's Saturday morning the next day. He texts me how he had a great time, and I did it then. I told him how uncomfortable I was, and that my anxiety was really triggered by how nervous he was, and that's why I didn't want to continue this anymore. I thought he took it pretty well. I was wrong. He wrote me saying how stupid my reason was, and that I wasted his time and money. I didn't ask him or want him to pay for me, and I even offered to pay him back every cent. He refused. A then took it upon himself to post all over his Facebook that I am the weirdo from Tinder, and what a shady person I am, that I completely used him for his money. Suddenly, I don't feel so bad anymore. TLDR. Met a guy on Tinder who turned out to be a total neckbeard, which I was unaware of until I met him. I dumped him and I end up being publicly dissed on Facebook.